Okay, back to the class. Now we are familiar with the three types of motion: rectilinear motion, circular motion, and periodic motion. We have just recalled out of your memory, and now you are familiar with it. So now we can move to our next topic: slow or fast. It's an easy topic. From the topic name of the topic itself, you are aware that slow or fast. In your text, you have given two pictures. In first picture, what can you see? The motion of cars in a road, along a straight road. But in the next picture, you can see some vehicles cover high distance or large distance rather than the balance of vehicles. So how can we say which car is slow or which car is fast? The car which covers high distance in a short interval of time, we can say that that car is moving more fast. The car which covers huge distance in a short time, then we can say that that car is moving fast. And the car which covers shortest distance in that particular time, we can say that that car is moving slow or it's going slowly. Now consider an example that you are using your bicycle to reach a bus stand, and a bus is also starting from a position to reach the bus stand. So the bus, at the moment the bus starts, you start your bicycle. But what happened? After 5 minutes, the bus reached the bus stand. But can you reach within that time the bus stand? With your bicycle, can you reach within 5 minutes to a bus stand? So here we can say that the bus is moving faster than you. You are slow than the bus, or the bus is moving faster than you. Now, you all have watched 100 meter race in your sports meet at school. You watched it, and 100 meter race. So how can you choose a winner, or how can you say who won the first prize? First, we will give the first trophy, second trophy, third trophy to the winners. So how can you say who is the winner? The student or the person who reached that 100 meters in a short interval of time, that person or that student will be the winner. I think all you are aware about a 100 meter race, or you have directly watched a 100 meter race. So how can we select a winner in that race? The student or the one who covers that 100 meter in a short time, then that person or that student will be the winner. So we will give him the first prize. Then we will look who is the one which covers the next 100 meter in the next short time. So we will give him second prize and the third prize, etc. So for measuring or for calculating the speed, how much speed he gained or he used to cover a certain distance, how can we calculate? Here in this example, we look that, or we calculate it by looking how much time that student or person takes to cover 100 meter. So what is the speed? We will calculate from it. So we can go to our next topic, speed, in detail. Okay. You are familiar with the word speed. Now you are aware about the word speed. For calculating speed or for looking after which person the distance covered by that one in a short time. Who covered a huge distance in a short time? For example, two persons are. The first person covers a distance, 1 kilometer in 2 minutes. The second person covers that same 1 kilometer in 4 minutes. So which person will have more speed? The first person. So for calculating speed or for indicating speed, we just look after which one covers a huge distance within a certain time, within a unit time. So we can say that speed is the distance covered by an object in a unit time. The distance covered by an object in a unit time, whether it be a person, a vehicle, etc., whether it can be, it could be any object. So the speed is simply that it is the distance covered by an object in unit time. Now, a vehicle is moving 50 km per hour. Our elders or our father or our cousins will say that I have completed 50 km in 1 hour. How you think what they are saying? It's just that they have completed a 50 km distance in 1 hour. If two persons are given a task that there are two vehicles and two persons going to move it, right? So we have asked them to move or to travel a distance of 50 km in 1 hour. If the first person is able to cover only 40 km in 1 hour and the second person has completed his target 50 km in 1 hour. So we can say that the second person having high speed rather than the first person. Because here the first person have just covered a distance of 40 km on your target, hence that we have to cover 50 km in 1 hour. So the first person just was able to cover only 40 km in 1 hour. But our second person has completed 50 km in that given 1 hour. So we can say that the second person is using more speed. We will not look that sometimes this person who have won the race, sometimes this person first will take his car slowly. Then after 1 kilometer or after 5 kilometer, he will increase his speed. But he will, because he completed 50 kilometer per hour in 50 kilometer in 1 hour. There is no matter in that. We should not look after that whether he uses his speed first or second stage, etc. He win the race because he covered 50 km in 1 hour. Up to 5 km, he goes slowly. But after that, he increases his speed. That doesn't matter in this case. Because the target is only that he has to cover 50 km in 1 hour. So we can say that he itself uses his speed. Speed is high in that case. And the first person, at the first kilometer itself, he uses his full speed, high speed. He uses. But he can't cover that 50 km in 1 hour. So we have to understand that this person has less speed and the next person who has covered the 50 km in 1 hour has more speed than this one. It's the difference. So the speed, we can simply say that an object moving in unit time or the distance covered by an object in unit time. Here in this chapter, the average speed is taken as speed in your chapter. The average speed, the average distance covered, the average speed means the average distance covered in a unit time. So in this chapter, instead of average speed, we use the term speed. Here the speed means the average speed used by the object or vehicle. So average speed, the equation for average speed, we can write that speed is the total distance covered by the total time taken. Now we have attained an equation for speed. What is that? speed is equal to total distance covered by total time taken. Now I hope that you all understand this topic and you should study the definition of speed, the distance covered by an object in unit time. It's so easy and we can write it as speed is equal to total distance by covered by total time taken. So today we have discussed about three types of motion: circular, periodic, rectilinear motion, and also how we can calculate the slow and fast of vehicles, persons, etc. And then we discussed about speed. Speed, as you all are familiar with the word speed. How can we measure, how can we calculate speed? Speed is the distance covered in a unit time. In a given time, the vehicle covers a certain distance. For example, 50 km per hour means we have to cover 50 km in that 1 hour. So we can say that speed is equal to total distance covered by total time taken. Here the total distance covered is 50 km and the total time taken is 1 hour. So we can simply say that speed is equal to total distance covered by total time taken. So don't forget to complete that table and send it to me. Okay, bye.